in Nebraska, where a teenager and her mother are facing criminal charges, allegedly because the teen aborted a fetus in violation of state law. Now, authorities are reportedly, they discovered this alleged abortion by way of Facebook messages. Now, while we won't show you a picture of the teen because she is a teen, even if she's being charged as an adult, this is 41-year-old Jessica Burgess. And she's pictured here, and she's being charged with 3 felonies in connection with her daughter. 3 felonies and 2 misdemeanors after helping her 17-year-old child perform an at-home abortion. And there was an article in Forbes that discussed this, and while I will read from the article itself, we will not put up the wording because in part they include the child's name, and I just don't think that that's acceptable. It's just not okay. This is a child who sought health care. What we know is that Norfolk Police Department, it received a tip claiming the teen had miscarried in April at 23 weeks of pregnancy and secretly buried the fetus with her mother's help. While the teen told police that she had suffered a miscarriage, they continued to investigate, serving Facebook with a search warrant to access the teen and Jessica's Facebook accounts. They subsequently found messages between the mother and daughter allegedly detailing how the teen had undergone a self-managed abortion with her mother's help. And also this per Vice, Facebook's DMs obtained by law enforcement were used as the main basis for a second search warrant in which 13 laptops and smartphones were seized from the Burgess's residence. 24 gigabytes of data, including images, messages, and web histories from their phones was extracted for the case. How ridiculous is this? The fact that we're using law enforcement resources to break into people's homes and their houses and figuring out what they're doing for their own health. This is exactly what people feared would happen with the reversal of Roe v. Wade, and it is coming to fruition. We have women, individuals being punished for seeking health care. This is some kind of dystopian nightmare. Continuing via Forbes, this marks one of the first instances of a person's Facebook activity being used to incriminate her in a state where abortion is restricted, a scenario that has remained largely hypothetical in the weeks following the US Supreme Court's decision to overturn Roe v. Wade. Nebraska currently outlaws abortions, but beyond 20 weeks. On Monday, Republican lawmakers in the state failed to secure enough votes to decrease that window to 12 weeks. This is incredibly disgusting. This is wild. It should not be happening anywhere in this world. This is healthcare. This is people seeking measures for their health, for their bodies, for their future. And as far as it concerns, when it comes to Facebook and their role in this matter, it really seems that the company has, its hypocrisy in full effect. A month before the teen was charged, Mark Zuckerberg, CEO of Facebook parent company Meta, was asked by employees how the company will protect those seeking abortion. Zuckerberg replied that efforts to expand encryption access or across the platform will keep people safe, CyberScoop reported. How safe is this gonna be? And I do very much understand when it's social media platforms seeking warrants, because I've sought one. I have subpoenaed social media platforms when I have been representing clients or seeking cases. And so I get it, and I know the process and how they respond. It's just extremely devastating and disgusting that Facebook did not push back. They should have been pushing back, fighting back. They have the resources. They could have kept this in the courts, and they could have made this difficult as hell for that law enforcement authority to have gotten those messages. Instead, it turned over with a quickness. This speaks volumes. AB?
Yeah, this is a danger that we face now when you have the government in control of your body, right? Instead of actual health professionals. I think one of the beautiful facts of Roe v. Wade, although controversial, was that at least the justice that wrote the opinion sought the advice and sought to do medical research to understand the effects that this would have on a woman or a person who gives birth, their body. So now we're faced with this, where we already have an unjust criminal justice system. We already have an overwhelming prison population. And now we are charging children as adults for making health decisions. How can our society be okay with this? This is gonna be a huge problem. I think we're now being more aware of the effect of overturning Roe v. Wade, of what this Dobbs decision has opened us up to as a country. And we really need to stop and think, are we okay with this? Changes need to be made. In addition to that, I don't like the fact that Facebook tried to use the excuse that the warrant was vague. I think they mentioned something about the warrant, said they were looking for a buried baby or something to that effect, or a baby that had been harmed. I think they should have double checked on that just to be on the safe side first, because the reality is now we see the type of tactics that can be used to get this type of information from these conservative states that want to prosecute people for making health decisions. So I think we're on a very dangerous, slippery slope right now. And I think the reality is maybe a lot of people didn't understand the effects that overturning Roe v. Wade would have had on us as a society. So now we really have to take a look at the decision that has been made and figure out how we can fix this, because this is going to cause a lot of issues. And again, we already have an overpopulated prison. This is not the type of thing we need to be sending people to prison for.
Nope, this is not how we should be spending our resources, and also not how law enforcement should be spending its resources, particularly given that law enforcement rarely ever prevents crimes at all. This is extremely problematic.